Good morning, students.
We started this lesson, that is fiber to fabric. In this last lecture, we discuss about the life cycle of silk moth. Okay.
And before this lecture, you may be drawn that diagram in your notebook also. Okay.
So now the next point we will start, that is known as a rearing of silkworm. See, sericulture. We discussed that one point, that is the sericulture. Sericulture means what? For the economic purpose, these all the silkworm is rare. Okay, they are doing the rearing. Rearing means what? To taking care of that particular, means that all the silkworm to get silk fiber. Okay, this is known as a sericulture. So in that point, the first point we will learn, that is the rearing of silkworm. Means how they are doing the rearing process. See, and why this rearing is done by them? Because see, this silk is very costly. Do you know all? And there are the varieties of silk. It's depend on the which type of silkworm is there. Okay, see the varieties of silk. The one point is there. That point we will discuss after this point. Okay, so. Because of that purpose, because of the economic purpose, this one or two silkworms to rear and to get the silk, it is not useful. So what happened? There are the one differently, one farm means they are doing this, the rearing of silkworm means to look after the silkworm by giving them proper food, shelter and health care. Means they are taking care of the silkworm. There are the many thousands and millions of silkworm they rear together. Okay, that is only known as a rearing of silkworm. Means what they are doing exactly? They rear a silkworm means to look after the silkworm by giving them proper food. Okay, you know that what is the food of a silkworm? Mulberry plant. Okay, they are giving the proper food, shelter and health care. Okay. This is known as a rearing of silkworm. Now, how means from cocoon to silk, how we are getting that? Okay, this is a process we will learn. See, here I written that from cocoon to silk means finally the silk fiber how to get. See, the first process is a boiling. See, now you know the stages, all the stages. First, what? The silkworm lay eggs, maybe around 200 to 500 eggs at a time that silkworm lay on a mulberry leaves. Okay, after that, what? After the hatching process, the silkworm comes out, means that eggs on one leaves after some time, after hatching the process, the silkworm comes outside. Okay, and then they feed on a mulberry plant. Mulberry plants, they are eating that more plants. And after this process, there is a next process, that is what? Pupa. Okay, and that time when that silkworm is moving head like this structure, see this we discussed in before lecture. Okay, the one liquid is comes out and it solidified, and that is the silk fiber. Okay, and it is totally around that silkworm. The silkworm is inside and it is moving ahead like this. So all whatever the liquid protein comes out, it is a solidified and it form a fiber. That process, when this process completed, and the next is a cocoon. That cocoons we are taking for this process. The first one is a boiling. Okay, that cocoons boil. Means in this process, they boil that cocoons. Why? Because see, after the cocoons, the silk moth is comes out. Means adult silk moth. If it will come out, then what? That cocoon will break and we will not get the strong or long fiber. So what, before to that stage, those are doing the rearing of silkworm. Those people are doing this for the economical purpose. They are the first process, cocoons directly they collected and they boil that in a hot water. In this boiling process, what happened? The silkworm down inside only, but they are getting the long and strong fiber. Okay, the next process is the reeling process. Next step is reeling. In this, what happened? The process of taking out thread from the cocoon is called as a reeling the silk. Now, in the boiling process, that silkworm kill inside only, and then outside, whichever the fiber they made, that fiber in this process, reeling process, they are taking out this thread from the cocoons and is called as a reeling of the silk. With that thread they are taking out and they are doing the reeling. Okay, after this, the throwing means they are the separating the fibers, strong fiber. And after that, the dyeing process, means they are giving a different color to that. See here, pictures is shown here. In this whole, this process is given how they boil that. It's after the boiling, what is the next step? That is also given. The next step is the reeling, and the reeling after this dyeing process is done. So color, see different color. Like this, all the silk material or silk fiber we are getting. So this is the process. Now see, this we discussed with the theoretically. Now I will draw here one diagram. This diagram means it is like a flowchart. Like this diagram, you have to write in your notebook. Okay, just write this all the points also. Okay, now see, before we discuss all the steps, now here the flow chart is given here. It is all the processes of how we are getting cocoon to silk. Means from cocoon to silk. See, the first step is female silkworm in a silk farm. Okay, this process, because of the economical purpose, this silkworm is rare. So that process is known as the rearing of silkworm. Okay, so your female silkworm in a silk farm. After that, that silkworm lay eggs around 200 to 500 on a mulberry tree. Okay, on a mulberry tree, means that leaf, mulberry leaves. Then after that, these eggs now comes out. But what, they are not waiting when these eggs will hatch and when the silkworm comes out. So what, it should be in a faster process. So because of that, these all the eggs are kept in an incubator. Now incubator means what? Here the temperature is more than the surrounding temperature, and because of the warmness, these eggs hatch and the larva or silkworm comes out. Okay, and then the silkworms come out, they feed on a mulberry plant. Means in the crushed form of mulberry, all the trees, plants, they provide them. They feed on the mulberry plant and then they increase in their size. They are eating a lot of the leaves. And then it goes into the next stage, that is the cocoons. Okay. And when they enter in a cocoon stage, then these cocoons are boiled. These cocoons are boiled in hot water, and then what, larva in cocoons die. So in this boiling process, whatever the larva or that silkworm present inside the cocoons, it is die because of this boiling process. If that larva or silkworms will come out, then they will not get a long fiber. Okay, so because of that purpose, the boiling process they did, and then the what, the fibers they will get, that process is known as a reeling. Then reeling process, after they are getting the silk thread. Okay, and then this silk thread, then the raw silk we got here. So in the reeling process, the raw silk we got here, and after that, this raw silk while dyeing process. Now dyeing means what? to give the different color, yellow color, blue color, black color, whichever the color. So keep all the colors. That process is known as a dye, and then color silk we got here. Okay, and the finally after the weaving process, the silk cloth we get. Okay, so this is the whole process how to get silk from cocoons. Okay, do you understand this process? See, this flowchart is very important. It is not given in your textbook, so write down this. If you will understand this flowchart, then you are able to write answers whenever the question will come. Okay, so read this lesson again one time. Only the last point is remaining in this lesson, that is the varieties of silk, that we will learn in next lecture. Thank you.